paraphrase Jim Burns, when things go south, those who stand by you, that's your family. Things go south at Crossroads fairly often. It's a busy restaurant in a historic hotel on the bustling campus of UNC. I stand before you today to honor and celebrate the staff that keeps everything together during basketball games, Christmas parties, and sorority events. I originally intended to present this staff, to present this speech to the staff. However, circumstance prevented me from doing so. So instead, I hope that you can come to know them over the next few minutes and lend me your enthusiasm in celebrating them. I started working at Crossroads in February of 2017, and over the past year, I have come to know the staff as hardworking, infallible, and kind. The staff is strong and unique, and I'll tell you why. Because we help each other no matter what's happening, we put in extra time, and we care not just for ourselves, but for the restaurant's success as a whole. So, whether we have far exceeded the fire marshal's maximum occupancy, or we're desperately buttering up our only guest, we try to help each other. Most of us have worked in more than one position in the restaurant, so we know intimately the needs and stresses of each role, and we strive to ease those stresses and fill those needs. So when Fitz is waiting tables in the dining room and he sees a million drink tickets, he immediately comes to make cocktails. When Tim sees a table that's been left uncleared, he stops washing dishes and he goes to clear it. Last night, Allison and James helped me close the bar so that I could go do my homework. But we don't just put in effort to help each other out. We put in extra time to make sure that the shifts run smoothly. Most of us already work more than full-time hours, but last football season, Nicole, Fitz, and I stayed late after a long day bartending so that we could cut lemons and make lime juice and make syrups for the next day's game. We also told stories and made jokes and ate pimento cheese. That kind of dedication to our craft and joviality in the face of utter exhaustion is what makes the place really special. And how could we not act that way with Victor as our leader? I don't think that Victor has ever worked a 40-hour week. He always leaves well after the bartenders do so that he can plan, order, and brainstorm. And the next day, he comes in ready to help to inspire us to do better. He never acts exhausted. He keeps us together. So with all the effort we put into helping each other and all the time we put in to prepare for events, Crossroads Restaurant has really become our restaurant. Alumni and townspeople come in with excited stories about the history of the inn, and that gives us a sense of responsibility to maintain the beautiful place they remember. So when I give a rosé to a table and excitedly tell them about our house chocolatier, I don't do it for extra money. I do it because I love Pierce's chocolate and I want them to know that he made it. And when we tediously push and pull the heavy marble tables to form a perfect line, when we check to make sure each napkin on each table is the same shade of brown, and when we neurotically adjust the volume of the music so that it matches the volume of our guests, we do that because we want to show the best version of our place to our guests. Crossroads Restaurant belongs to its staff. So, to the helpful, hardworking, and passionate staff of Crossroads, I appreciate you. Through triumph and failure, we stand by each other. We are a family. Thank you.